All right, Gabrielle Ruiz just said the greatest thing when she walked in. She said she is here, business casual ready.
Business casual. Yeah. What do you think, guys?
No, it's great. Yeah. I like it.
In the pants.
Thank you. I know you can't see them, but pajamas are back in.
Yes.
You know, and it's a good excuse for me.
Would you wear pajamas everywhere if you could?
If I could, absolutely. Tucked in, tucked out, with a belt, whatever you want, red lipstick, you're ready.
Yeah.
Don't you think?
I am down with that.
When you and Lin-Manuel were doing In the Heights on Broadway, no less.
No.
And then how did he recommend you for the show?
I know that the creative team for Crazy Ex-Girlfriend was looking for some singer, actor, dancer types for the role of Valencia, which is the role I play. You know the spoiler, I got the job. But at the same time, they were looking for singer, actor, dancers, triple threats.
Yeah.
And they reached out to Lin-Manuel, who recommended me.
Wow.
Yes,
that's
yes.
Great. Do you love the name Valencia?
Valencia is so much fun. It's also a fun name to twist and turn that Donna Lynn Chaplin's character, Paula, always makes fun of all the time. She says Valerio and... You know, just makes fun of my name all the time. And it's so vivacious.
Yes, vavoom.
Yeah, vavoom.
There.
The V is such a strong letter for her energy.
We often talk about and shows celebrate certain milestones, 100th anniversary. But you're saying 100 has got a special place.
Yes.
This is so interesting.
Yes, for season 3, we have reached 100 original songs for our show.
Wow.
Yes, and you'll see that through the season of... season 3 of Crazy Ex-Girlfriend.
And are these like shooting music videos or what's it like?
They are like music videos. They're production numbers. We are given the song sometimes the day before. The song that you're seeing right now, Women Gotta Stick Together, I received those lyrics the day before we shot.
Wow.
And Catherine Burns, our choreographer, was kind of spitting out the words to me one measure before.
Yeah.
And it's a lot of trust. It's a lot of team effort to get everything on its feet, like you see on TV.
And this is, I tell you what, a show where, and I've had this conversation with Rachel, where awards attention has been oxygen for the show.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's true. That's true, yeah.
What's new for the third season?
What's new for the third season? I feel like Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, the word, the title that many people either were confused about or overwhelmed about, they weren't sure what it was, it is now completely defined at its fullest. So,
So she's completely crazy.
So I think we kind of all are. I'm not gonna lie. It's a lot of girl power. We're supporting her. She was left at the altar.
Right.
Valencia was planning her wedding. I mean, she started off as an enemy and then frenemy and then friend. Valencia was figuring out what a friend or a girlfriend was, and then she ends up planning her ex-boyfriend's wedding, if you think about it, and she's abandoned at the altar. So here we go.
Here we
get
go.
Ready. Here's
a, this is a sneak peek clip. Watch.
All men are completely repressed.
Uh-huh.
All men only want to have sex. There are no exceptions. All 3 billion men are like this.
All 3.6 billion men.
All men are emotionally stunted.
When asked how they feel, every man's always grunted.
And why do men never listen and only think about themselves?
As opposed to women who always listen and never think about themselves.
Ooh, I hear you, girl.
Let's generalize about men. Let's generalize about men.
Oh, that's funny.
The new anthem here at KTLA. But how many of those generalizations do you think hit the nail on the head?
All of them. All of them. There was one lyric, too. There's like, what about gay men? Oh, no, they're great.
Yeah.
They're just sassy. I mean, they're all just sassy. You know what I mean? Just, it's really, really fun.
All right, on the crack research we've done,
okay.
Tell me if this is true or not.
Okay.
Is it true that you eat pizza with a fork?
I do eat pizza with a fork.
Really?
So does my mom, and we tease her about it. And so does
that's how they do it in Italy.
It's the best way to do it. It slows me down. If not, it's
that's
just kind of like one big motion, and I don't chew the slice of pizza. So it slows me down. I get to enjoy a little bit more.
So is this applicable to any and all? Like, if we brought Domino's in, you'd ask for a knife and fork?
I would, but then I would still eat it.
Right.
Even if the fork and knife was not here.
Okay.
And I would also ask for ranch dressing, because I'm a Texan.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. Well.
See that? Oh, we were getting along so well till then.
Good.
Ranch dressing on pizza?
Always.
Really?
Always.
Always.
Oh,
wow.
Isn't that great? Don't knock it till you
do. Do you have a go-to brand?
As long as it's thin crust, I'm good.
No, the ranch dressing.
Ranch dressing.
Yeah.
Oh, probably Hidden Valley, but just ranch all the way.
Okay.
Yeah. See, I used to do it as a kid, but then I felt like I was shamed out of it. You know, where it's like, you're doing what? And I
just be yourself.
Gave it up.
Just be yourself.
But we had a producer here who would have ranch with everything.
Everything.
Like hot chocolate? Some ranch, please.
Are they from the South?
Yeah,
yep,
it's a total Texas thing.
It's a Texas
thing.
That
is crazy. Yeah. Well, this is the most important thing. Season 3 of Crazy Ex-Girlfriend will premiere tomorrow night, 8 o'clock Friday night, here on KTLA. So nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
And the PJs do the whole thing.
Thank you so much.
Good luck.
You are the triple threat.
Shoulder pads are in.
There. Yeah.